welcome back to Albany Pair. Guys, thank you guys for watching and subscribing to the channel. It means a lot. In today's video, guys, we'll be working here on a Dodge Journey, which is the same as Fiat Fremont. And what we'll show you guys how to remove or how to replace the front left seat belt, the driver's side seat belt. So on that Dodge Journey, guys, and the whole generation, the procedure should be the same. This is your driver seat belt, guys. Often those things, if you're in a crash or something, they go bad. Spring will break. Even if you're not in a crash, sometimes you have to replace them. So stay with us. That's what we'll be covering, how to remove and replace it. In the meantime, we'll have more than 200 videos on this car. So please, guys, subscribe to the channel for more videos. Our mission is to save you as much money as we can. So let's start on the process now. So we'll move the seat all the way to the front. Okay, perfect. You can see right here, okay, we have one cap. This cap, we'll need to remove it. So I'm going to hold this thing up. Okay, while one person with a panel remover too. Okay, he's going to slide the cap up. Perfect. Okay, just like that. You can see how it slides up like that. You don't pry it out. Now, right here, guys, okay, that's where the bolt for the seat belt will be located to. Okay, this bolt right here. And this one looks like it's a Torx 50. So we're going to go ahead and check it out. Now, I'll recommend, guys, okay, to disconnect your car battery at least 1 hour before you start working on the seat belt, okay, after you move the seat and all that stuff, because it's part of the airbag system and you don't want to cause any trouble. You don't want something to blow in your face. Be careful, guys. Consider this entertaining video. So disconnect your car battery at least 1 hour, okay, before you proceed removing the belt and disassembling more stuff. Now, this is Torx 50, started looking a bit like this one here. Okay, getting it loose now. Perfect, you can see we removed it just like that. Now, okay, let me show you what else we need to do. That cover right there, that little cover. Okay, we need to pry it up. Okay, perfect, just like that. It has only three clips that go in place. We need to do the same thing to the rear trim right here. Okay, somebody broke those, as you can see. They didn't install them the correct way. Now, let me show you, okay, what we need to do right here now. So right there, we have one cap that we need to remove. Okay, that says airbag. Okay, this is the cap, and underneath it we have a Torx screw. I can see it. I don't think I will be able to show you. Looks like it's a Torx 20 screw. Yep, a little bit down right there. So we'll go ahead and remove this one now. It'll be interesting to see how we're going to install that later. Now we have a couple more clips that we need to remove there. The bottom piece comes out first, actually. You see, most of the cars will be the top one. On this one, it's the bottom piece that comes out first. Let us show you where all the clips are now. Okay, you have 1, 2, 3 foam clips. Perfect. And now we can go ahead, pull that piece. Okay, the screw stays in there. If you don't take it all the way off, it will stay in there. So that's a good advantage, because that way we cannot drop it later. Now, this is guys your belt here. And we need to go ahead, disconnect the belt and disconnect the airbag wires. Okay, and you have more crash sensors there as well. Down there you can see. So quite a few things here now. Okay, Torx 50 socket again. Okay, this is the bolt right there. Now on the bottom you have to be careful, because that thing is part of the airbag system. I told you, you have to disconnect your car battery, so you have to be extremely careful. Now right here, press that thing out. Okay, perfect. Next. Check it out now. One more bolt down there. That's a crash impact acceleration sensor, the blue one there, so be careful. We might need to go get the bigger tools here now. So you can see this one is quite tight. So we're going to get a few more things, but from that point on guys, okay, check it out. This is your connector for the airbag. Okay, it's black with yellow, and this is your crash sensor, the blue thing. So let's see if the little impact is going to take. No, that thing is way, way too tight. So we give it one more try. I don't know if it has rust, if it has thread locker or something. We'll see why that bolt is not going easy at all. Okay, let's try now to cheat the system. Okay, check it out guys, all that is thread locker. Check out how much thread locker. So we need to put some thread locker later on the board when you put new belt. Now we pull the, okay, the belt out, very careful. This is your airbag connector, okay, right here. And how we'll disconnect those, okay. First, I wouldn't recommend using metal tools. Find something small plastic, but if you don't have any, okay, pry it up. Like that, and now grab and pull straight out. Do not twist them. No, never go in an angle. Never twist this way. You have to go straight up. Okay, you can see it's coming out. Okay, like that. If you twist, you're going to damage your pins, you're going to damage your connector, and those things are expensive to replace. So, you can see guys, this is the belt out of the way. That's how you guys remove it. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe to the channel for more videos, and see you guys next time.